Kata is karate, and karate is kata. You wouldn't have modern karate, you wouldn't have karate at all, if you didn't have kata. You'd have some kind of boxing, or kickboxing, or something like that. Karate is based on kata. Kata is what allowed this fighting method to be transferred from China, literally 2,000 years ago, to modern time. I can perform movements that were performed in China 1,000 years ago. I have a good idea how that person fought because I know that kata that's been passed down for who knows how long, how many hundreds of years. Originally, up until about 1920s, karate was taught by a teacher to a few students, maybe one or two. So each teacher took the kata, and the purpose of that kata was to teach the student to fight. It wasn't to perform in front of a crowd, or it wasn't to win a trophy, or it wasn't to be promoted to a rank. It was to learn how to fight. So the teacher took the kata and adapted it to teach his students how to fight. Karate was all teacher-student, no big organizations at all. So those katas, over time, evolved because one teacher thought it was better this way, one teacher thought it was better this way, one teacher thought it was better this way. The katas complement each other. For example, if you learn Goju-ryū katas, the Goju-ryū katas, one feeds into the next kata. So you're kind of building your repertoire of movement by learning more than one kata. The logical reason you learn more than one kata is you learn more than one way of fighting, more than one, because they all have a group of techniques within them. So you learn this group of techniques, and you learn this group of techniques, and you learn this group of techniques. So you expand your arsenal of fighting techniques by learning more katas. The whole idea of what karate is changed in 1901 from being a survival secret, very secret survival art. In 1901, Itosu Sensei started teaching in schools. And to teach kids, a group of kids who are 12 years old or 13 years old in a middle school, you're not going to teach them what you taught some guy in a cemetery on how to live through a battle. You're teaching them gymnastics. You're teaching them philosophy. You're teaching them power and strength and that kind of stuff. So Itosu Sensei changed all the katas. Most all of the katas. But a lot of the katas that he passed on, you might want to say, dumbed down. And he took the martial movements out of them, and he changed them to blocks or less martial things.